If you clicked on this title, I know you're very eager to get into the list, how to increase your milk supply naturally and extremely quickly. If you guys are new to my channel, please be sure to go check out my breastfeeding struggle story. If you're struggling with supply, I've been there, I've done that. Also, I wanted to make this video with a list of things that I know have worked for me as far as increasing the supply very quickly, using things that your body already naturally does to help increase that supply instead of squandering your money on cookies and shakes and green drinks and blue Gatorade and things like that that aren't really scientifically proven to increase your supply at all. Super excited because I love helping people breastfeed their baby. It is one of the best things I've ever done in my life, and I want to help as many people as I can breastfeed their own babies. So let's get right into this list. So the number one thing that you should definitely do if you're having supply issues and you want to increase supply very quickly is make sure that you are hydrated. I know I drink way more water now than I ever have my entire life. Every time I feed Gianna, I get thirsty, extremely thirsty. I know it takes a lot of the water from your body, so make sure you're hydrated. I also think this is the reason why you'll see, like on Instagram, the pink drink from Starbucks. People say that helps their supply, or the blue Gatorade, or certain kind of juices, naked juices, things like that. You'll see those trends go through Instagram as milk boosters. Well, I don't really think it's anything specific in those drinks that is actually boosting your milk. It's the hydration. If you're downing these drinks thinking it's helping your supply, you're hydrating or overhydrating yourself, and that of course is going to increase your supply. I think your milk is like 90% water, so if you're ingesting more water, then you're going to produce more milk. So you could have just drank your own water or like bottled water, and you probably would have gotten the same results. But we all know those pink drinks and blue Gatorade and all that kind of stuff tastes way better than water. So if that's what works for you, that's what works. But just make sure you stay hydrated. So that's number one. Number two on this list, make sure you move milk to make milk. Your breasts work like this. When your breasts are empty, they send signals to your milk ducts to produce more milk. If your breasts are not empty, your body thinks that baby doesn't need any milk right now. So if you want to increase your supply very quickly, move that milk, pump it out. If the baby's not hungry, pump it out. Your body will then send signals to make more milk. So if you want to increase your supply, that is definitely, after hydration, the number one way to increase your supply is move the milk. You could do this by power pumping. That is something that you do after every feed. So whether you're feeding baby or you're pumping to feed baby, then you're going to do another pump session on top of that for every feeding. So that will greatly increase your supply very, very quickly. If you feel like your supply is just dipping down very low, that's something you can do. So that would be number two, is move the milk to make the milk. The number three way to increase your milk supply naturally and extremely quickly is to latch that baby. So moving milk any kind of way is going to help your body make more milk, but latching your baby, the baby's saliva is like an ignition for a lot of things. So latch the baby as much as possible. If you found yourself, your supply dipped a little bit when you tried to go back to work, or you're not just latching the baby as much, you're bottle feeding more, try to go back to latching the baby a little bit more. Maybe add a couple of night feedings or an extra in the middle of the night feeding to just get that latch on, and you will see your supply increase. So number four way to increase your milk supply is kind of related to number three, but it is skin to skin contact. This is a great way to increase your milk supply and also just increase that bond between you and baby. It's incredibly important to do skin to skin contact with your baby, not just when they're newborn, but all throughout their life, really. As far as it goes with breastfeeding, skin-to-skin contact actually increases your milk supply. So what I like to do is actually take baths with Gianna. I used to give her baths separately in the kitchen sink, but now we just take baths together in our master bathroom, and it's been great. I'm actually noticing an extra ounce in every feeding she's doing since I started these baths. So skin-to-skin contact is huge, and I highly, highly recommend it. Number five is massage. We all love massages, and so do our milk ducts, okay? So if you have an older baby like me, Gianna actually does the massage for me. I no longer have to do it. She squeezes the breast, she hits it, sometimes she punches it, but she does the massage herself. I don't have to do it anymore. But if you have a younger baby and if you're having supply issues, massaging your breast, and there's a certain way to do it, it's actually more of a compression rather than like an actual massage. It's like you hold and press your breast against your chest, and you move from area to area kind of slowly to release the milk. But this can give you a lot of extra milk in each feeding. Eventually your baby's going to start doing this, whether you did it or not. And that is just nature's way of showing you what you could have done to increase your milk supply this entire time, breast massage. You can also Google this on YouTube. I know there's a few videos of women actually showing you how to do the massage, and they're super, super helpful. Or I will drop the link below to a couple of videos I remember watching about the breast massage that were really, really good. But that is a great way to get more milk. You can even massage under your armpit, under your breast. There's so many milk ducts all around the breast area that you could just get extra milk out, whether you're pumping or feeding the baby. Number six and seven are the only supplements that I'm going to recommend. Like I said at the beginning of the video, you don't really need supplements. I would try all of the first things first. I would try 1 through 5 first. It costs you absolutely no money to do those things. But if you are still seeing your supply is low, or maybe you're like me, you already got your cycle back. And I noticed during my cycle, either during my cycle or right before my cycle, I noticed a pretty big drop in supply to the point where Gianna was starting to wake up more at night. So I started doing these other things, which I'm about to get into for 6 and 7. So these are some of the things that I will do around that time to just make sure my supply is good. But like I said, don't get tripped up into trying to buy like a bunch of crap for increasing your supply. Breastfeeding is all natural thing, and your body knows what to do. And there's certain things that you can help it trigger itself to make more milk rather than just like buying a bunch of stuff. Number six, and I know for sure this works for me. Of course, with any kind of supplement, it may not work for you. For example, fenugreek. A lot of people will tell you to take fenugreek or mother's milk tea. That actually had the reverse effect on me. It made me make less milk, and my milk was not as thick and creamy as it normally was. So that didn't work for me at all. It actually was bad for me. So try any kind of supplement, you know, gauge it, only try one at a time so you know if it's working for you or not. That is another thing with like milk cookies and things like that. You don't really know which ingredient in there is the one that's actually working for you. So I like just doing them singular by themselves. It's a lot less expensive. You get a way more product that'll last you a lot longer time. But let me just get into 6 and 7 and stop babbling, okay? So number six is brewer's yeast. Now this stuff is like magic. How I discovered that brewer's yeast worked for me was I was making these booby bites, which are lactation cookies that you can make at home yourself. I love making them. They're super delicious. I love making them just to eat them, but they definitely helped my supply. And I was like, what is in here that is really boosting my supply? I mean, to the point where my milk was shooting out of my breast, and I'm not a shooter. I don't even leak at all, ever. So that was huge. I started really paring down the ingredients and trying them one at a time. And it was the brewer's yeast in it that was making it my supply like crazy high. So brewer's yeast tablets, I just get them from Walmart. They're literally like $5.32 for 250 tablets. So this is what they look like. And it's just brewer's yeast. That's the only ingredient in it. And like I said, I just got them from Walmart, and they were literally like $5 and some change. and these work tremendously. Now, when I Googled like how many to take, what I read said to take 3 tablets 3 times a day. I felt like that was a lot of tablets, so I started with just 3, and that worked. And then I did 3 2 times a day, and that went overboard. Like, I was making so much extra milk. So for me, 3 tablets 2x a day is like, if I really need to turn it on overnight, that's what I'm gonna do. So you have to just gauge it and see what works for you. But I love it. The only side effect I really see from them is the smell. Like, my urine and her urine will smell kind of like brewer's yeasty, I guess. But it doesn't give your body like an odor or any kind of like odor down there, like on a regular basis. It's just when you urinate, you can smell it coming out. So that was the only, like, I guess, weird side effect that I saw. And also, my lactation consultant told me that brewer's yeast is a B vitamin and that it helps with depression and anxiety, which I did not know. So there's an added benefit to taking brewer's yeast that is a mental capacity, which I think is great. Number 7, the last tip that I have for you to really increase your supply. This is more so maintaining your supply and just having a healthy supply. So number 7 is oatmeal and flaxseed. And I'm beginning to see a lot of more of this already pre-mixed on the market. There's like, you know, instant oatmeal with flaxseed mixed in, which is a like indicator, I guess that's supposed to be like a hot thing to do. But I just get my really like $2 for a huge container of flaxseed, and it's in a shaker. So it's super helpful in the morning. Just pour your oatmeal, sprinkle a little flaxseed on top. The flaxseed makes the oatmeal super creamy and just more filling. And it's full of good fats, and flaxseed and oatmeal have been known to boost milk supply. But again, like I said, I eat that every morning, and if I miss it or don't eat it for a couple days, it's not like my supply dips out of nowhere. Like, I think it's more of a maintenance food and a health food for your milk supply. So I really hope this video helped you. I really want to encourage you to breastfeed if you're just starting out. I know it can be super hard. Like I said, please go check out my breastfeeding story if you haven't already. I'll drop the link below. I struggled in the beginning with supply. I even had to supplement. So I've been there, girls. You are not alone. So I hope this video helped you. If it did, please give it a big thumbs up. And be sure to subscribe to this channel if you like mommy and family videos. And until the next one, I will see you later. Bye.